children. Today we are going to start with the chapter number 5, Presentation Visual Effects. In this chapter, we are going to learn introduction to the PowerPoint, applying animation effects, adding transition effects, inserting sound and video clips, using action buttons, importing data from Word, and viewing presentation and slide master. Today we are going to start with the topic Introduction to PowerPoint from page 46. Here in this topic we will learn how to create presentation, how to insert picture in our slide, how to run presentation, and how to exit the slideshow. Before going to start the chapter, let's discuss few terms that we are going to learn from the page 46. Here the first term is PowerPoint, where PowerPoint is a presentation software used to make the presentations. As we all know, to do any work in computer, we need some specific application softwares, and the PowerPoint is the application software through which we are going to make the presentations in our computer. The next term is there, presentation, where presentation means a group of slides arranged in sequential manner, such as we are having a book. The complete book contains small pages inside, and the whole book is known as the presentation. In the same way, the presentation contains a number of slides that are arranged in specific order, and that is known as the presentation. The next term is there, slide, where slide is like a page in presentation. As we have discussed, the presentation is like a book, and the each page inside the book is known as a slide. In that way, a slide in a presentation is like a page in a book. Next, we are going to learn few icons that we will learn from page 46. The first icon is there, new slide. Here the slide page is given with the star on it. That is, this icon is known as the new slide icon. The next icon is there, where is a page with the turn at the one corner. This icon is known as the create or blank presentation icon. The next icon is there of picture icon. Other icon is there of clip art icon. The next we will learn from here, that is from beginning icon. From here the slides have been shown in order one by one. And the next icon is there of add animation. You can see the plus sign is there, where it means you can add more animation effects in your slide. Next, we will learn few shortcut keys from this chapter. The first shortcut key that we will learn, that is to run the presentation. To run our presentation, we need F5 key. And to end the slideshow, we press escape key from the keyboard. Now open your computer book at page number 46, chapter number 5, Presentation Visual Effects, the concepts of PowerPoint 2016, where I have already discussed the term presentation slide earlier. Now we will also learn how we can communicate with the people through our presentations, and how can we insert pictures, shapes, charts, etc. in our presentation that we have already done in the previous classes. There are few new features in the PowerPoint 2016 that makes the presentations more interesting and more attractive. We will learn those features later on in this chapter. Now let's see it practically. Click on start button. Click on Microsoft PowerPoint 2010 from start submenu. After clicking on PowerPoint 2010, you can see the Microsoft PowerPoint window on your screen. Here you can see the topmost bar, that is known as the title bar, where it displays the name of the presentation and the name of the application, where the presentation 2 is the name of presentation and Microsoft PowerPoint is the name of application software. Below the title bar, you can see the tabs. Here is the File tab, Home tab, Insert tab, Design tab, Transition, Animation, Slideshow, Review and View tabs. Below the tabs, you can see these small groups. These small groups are divided into smaller parts. These shows the commands of related objects. And the tabs and the groups are combinedly known as the ribbons. Below the ribbon, you can see this pane. This pane is known as the slides pane. Here you can see the individual slide on your slides pane. And the next to it is outline pane, where you can see the slide and its contents individually. Here you can see I have given a heading in the title placeholder, and you can see the smaller slide pane view and the text outside the slide. This is called the outline view. In the slides view, you can see directly full slide within the text in itself. Now the next thing is there, the small dotted area on the slide. This is known as the slide or page of the presentation where we are doing work. In this page, this small dotted area is known as the placeholder. This placeholder is used to type the text. Click inside the placeholder and you can type text inside. Now select your placeholder and go to the Home tab. We can make changes in our text. Suppose I want to make the text color change, want to make it bold, and also want to change the size of the text. I can do it from here. In the same way, select the content placeholder and select the size of the text, make it bold and change its color as per your choice. Now the next thing you can see from here, on your slide, if we want to insert the next slide, how can we do that? You can see on the Home tab in the slides group, the new slide icon is there. After clicking on this icon, the new slide will be inserted on your slide pane. You can see the drop down arrow is there in the new slide. From there you can choose any layout from the new slide button. These are the ready-made patterns used to do work with our slides. For example, if we are selecting the title and content, in the title and content slide you can see all these small icons will present on your slide. Thus, by clicking on these icons, we can simply insert these things on our slide quickly. Now the next thing is there, select the first slide that we have made before. Now if we want to change the design of our slide to make it look beautiful, how can we do that? Firstly, select the slide, go to the design tab, and these designs you can see from here. These are the predefined themes in your Microsoft PowerPoint window. By selecting on any theme, you can apply on your slides. For example, I have chosen here this theme. So on our all the slides, the themes will be applied automatically. Other thing we can also do on our slides, click on the second slide. From here you can insert picture by single clicking on this icon, or We can also insert pictures in a slide by clicking on Insert tab. In Insert tab, you can see Image Group. Here we can insert picture from the picture button or clip art from the clip art button. Where picture button is showing us the pictures that are saved in our computer, and clip art shows us the pictures that are available in our Microsoft PowerPoint window. Firstly, we will insert the picture from picture icon. Now firstly click on the picture icon. It will show you the pictures that are stored in your computer. For example, I have selected the pictures from here. Thus I can insert any picture according to our choice. By clicking on the picture icon, click on Insert button. The picture will be inserted on your screen. You can drag the picture on your slide by holding down these points on your picture, and the double-headed arrow will appear. Pressing the mouse button and dragging it, you can select the size of the picture according to your choice. Thus, we have inserted picture in our slide. Next, we can also insert clip parts. The same option you can get from the Insert tab, or you can insert the option from the content placeholder on your slide. After clicking on clip art icon, by single clicking on the clip art icon, you can see the clip art pane on the right side of your PowerPoint window. By clicking on the Go button, you can see all the pictures available in your Microsoft PowerPoint library. For example, I have chosen a picture here of. By single clicking on the icon, now the clip art will be inserted. Now drag the icon to arrange the size of the picture on your slide. Now notice one more thing. After clicking on the picture, or when we have inserted any clip art, you can see on the type tabs there the new format tab will appear after clicking on the picture or any object that we have inserted. From the format tab, you can see down the picture's style. From here, you can choose any style of the picture as per your requirement. For example, I have chosen a picture style here, this. Thus our picture will be look into the more attractive format. The next one more thing that we can insert on our slide is shapes. Let's see how can we insert shapes in our slide. Click on Insert tab. Here in Insert tab, you can see under Illustrations group the shapes icon. By clicking on the shape icon, you can choose any shape from there. By right clicking on this shape, click on Edit Text, and you can type text here. Again, we can change the text effects by selecting the text, click on Home tab, make it bold, bigger, and we can change also its color. We can also change the shape's color. By clicking on the Format tab, you can see the different shape colors options are available there. By selecting any color from the shape fill, you can see the shape's color will be look like this. Now you can see we can also insert the background picture of our slide from our computer. Let's see how can we do that. click on any slide that you want to change the background picture. Now right click on the slide on the empty area. You can get the pop-up menu list. From the pop-up menu list, you have to select the format background option. After clicking on format background option, you can see the format background dialog box will appear. From the format background dialog box, you have to select the picture or texture fill option. After selecting on picture or texture fill option, you have to select the picture from file. Click on the file button. It will display the pictures that are available in your computer. Now click on any picture that you want to insert. After selecting picture, click on insert button. Now the background of your slide will be changed according to your requirement. Now here you can see I have made a presentation of 4 slides where I have chosen the topic save trees. To choose this topic, I have inserted text save trees, I have inserted background image, and I have selected any picture. In the next slide also, I have taken picture and text. And in the next slide, I have taken the different text and shape with the images. Thus, I have made the 5 slides of this topic. Now, after completing our presentation, let's display it in a slideshow. How can we display it in a slideshow? 2 ways are there to display the slides in a slideshow. The first is there. From the slideshow tab, click on from beginning button, or you can press from your keyboard F5 key. Now after clicking from beginning icon, your presentation will be shown in a slideshow. Now it is visible in a slideshow view. By using the next arrow key from the keyboard, you can go to the next slide. Then again by clicking on next button from the keyboard, you can move to the next slide. Again, our next slide is there. Now, to exit the slideshow, we have to press the escape key from the keyboard. After clicking on escape key from the keyboard, you can see our presentation will be appear in the normal view. Now create an interesting presentation as I have shown to you by yourself. Till now we have discussed from the page 46 following terms. We have discussed PowerPoint, presentation, slide, and we have also discussed few icons, that is new slide, create blank presentation, picture, clip art, from beginning, add animation, the shortcut keys that we have used to run presentation is F5 key, and to end slideshow we have used escape key. Now revise all the terms, shortcut keys and icons till done.